We have three people searching on it from the... Oh, I found it.
Well, hello there. How you doing? Welcome to the video. Nice to see you.
How you doing?
Sit right back, relax, and buckle up. It's time to boogie. Let the show begin.
Time to boogie.
Only take a few minutes of your time. Make a smile, maybe giggle, or blow your mind. So do a little dance and like this video.
What is going on, everyone? Sidearms here, aka Sidearms. And if you can see behind us, we have five legendaries on our team right now. If we look over here somewhere, there he is. We got another one, boys, and here's how we caught it.
Ours, boys.
Take it from his bitch ass.
Where is it? Who did it spawn on?
It spawned on. It said, what did it say?
He's
jungle,
mine.
Jungle
nope,
M.
You weren't here. You claimed it. So, Sidearms already claimed it.
Yeah.
Not too bad. Sidearms ain't gonna catch shit.
Finders keep.
Sidearms, yeah. Are you even here, Sidearms?
I'm fucking right here.
He's right there.
It spawned in Jungle M, and the Jungle M is over here somewhere.
So yeah. It spawned on me, so it's mine.
Yeah, it actually did spawn on D20, probably. We have to be careful and find it. Finders, keepers, losers suck dick, something like that. I can't remember.
That's what our teacher said. Yeah.
And let me...
Dude, these things are so fucking hard to find, dude.
We have three people searching on it from the... Oh, I found it.
Nice.
Fuck... You guys, somebody.
Feel
guys.
It, I swear.
I mean, just deluxe.
Where's it at?
I ain't telling you shit. If no, it's by like stuff. I don't know. It's like
from
under
the
one of the trees.
What?
It's
from
like
where from the waterfall?
If you look at the waterfall, it's on the left. It's okay. On the left, that side. Fuck, he keep fucking broke on the second.
Find it so fast, holy fuck!
I lucky dude. There's no way this is.
Where was it at, Seth? No.
If you look at the waterfall, it's on the
no,
left.
No, I see where you're at.
Okay, that's where I'm at. That's right under me.
Yeah, I don't see you. I'm looking at D20.
Oh, well. Well, I don't really know. I see a Metagross. Oh, it just transformed into my Metagross. I'm under one of the trees.
Oh, I see you.
There's trees all up the mountain.
Shadow, are you here? I gotta ask you a question. You fucking me too.
This what you want, bro?
No. I want a Mew. I'm afraid to, like, hit it, dude.
Yeah, I wouldn't hit it.
Or this.
Jesus.
Or this guy.
I the camera angle switched so I can't see. Let me just try a regular Pokeball. This is what Ash Ketchup caught him with, right? I don't actually think Ash caught him. Well, he broke free. Fuck me. Shadow.
I've never found it.
Do you see G18? G18, you can tell him the coordinates if you want. I got it. Fuck yes, dude. Yeah.
Still want to see where it was.
It was, go to 38. Actually, G18, stay here, and then I'll grab the other guys, okay?
I'm at the waterfall right now.
Alright, I'll come get you guys at the waterfall. It was pure luck.
I'm right here.
Okay.
Lined up at the waterfall.
Do you see us, at least? Behind you, like...
Right in front of you.
Yeah.
Yeah, gotcha.
He was over here. In this little crevice. He was not where G18 was standing, but right, well, fuck it. I'll just take some fall damage right here.
Really? Wow, yeah. Dude, it's far away.
I think he spawned closer to D20 than anyone else.
Yeah, so I'm gonna need you to trade that to me.
I mean, I don't know. This is because it's kind of weird.
Now that you guys saw that, time to be completely honest. I don't think. All right, Jigglypuff. Don't worry, bro. Not trying to just intro a video or anything, but okay. So, well, I guess it puts all my Pokemon in balls for me, so I don't have to do any of that kind of stuff anymore. But, we're probably going to get rid of Articuno, sadly. Now, the reason I say that is because we already have a lot of stuff that's going to be weak to electric anyway. And I think that okay, so here's my plan, okay? So these are down here are the Pokemon that I would use, like, in case. Oh, by the way, here's the thing that D4 caught. I'll show this in the video right now.
That's Egg Hatch. You're welcome.
You're welcome, by the way.
Stupid ass piece of shit, lady.
You better not go to the PC right now and throw it in the trash.
Oh, that's what I'm doing. I'm trying to find my house, go to the Pokemon Center, and then
hey,
toss
don't
that
worry.
Shit
there's
in the
plenty
trash.
More where that toss came from, you piece of shit.
And then we have a whole bunch of other stuff. We just have stuff laying around. I still have to get presents for G18, Shadow, and D4. I don't think Shadow and D4 want one for whatever reason. So probably just G18. I think, you know, he did give me the Master Ball and everything that I caught Lugia with. So, so right now, for now, so here's my plan, basically. Oh, okay. So another quick tip, quickie. I know this is kind of all over the place, but these blonde haired trainers always give like 4,000 plus Pokédollars. So I always try to kill them so we can try to get some extra cash. Today, what we're going to do actually is we are going to, yeah, see, 4,320. Fucking easy, bros. So what I want to do today, though, is I want to go over to the power plant and teach that Master Ball Guardian dude a fucking lesson, okay? Because he has been shitting on a bunch of people. And you know what? We're just going to have to go and take him out. But I guess let me try to explain that stuff I was talking about, Articuno. So, for, like, whenever we do that whole tournament thing at the end with the rest of the guys, I want, like, I do want to have a full legendary squad. And if we don't have a full legendary squad, like, minus Articuno, till then, I'll just use Articuno instead, probably. Even though that's probably not the best idea, since, like, fucking one electric type can be pretty devastating to me. And why is this loading so slow? But, we already have a lot of stuff that's already weak to electric, and Articuno is really weak to rocks, like stealth rocks they're called. If someone puts them out on the field, then we're just going to get wrecked. But the reason I'm going to use Mew, oh yeah, let me show you guys Mew's IVs. Mew's IVs aren't that great. You can see it at the top right there. But here, it's all right, I guess. I mean, not really, but I still like them. Mew, one of the OGs. I think we're going to try to get Mewtwo too, or Mewtwo as well, lol. But I don't think that it's going to, like, I'm not in a rush to get it, you know, because we already have a bunch of offensive people, and, like, we already have a special attacker, which is Kyogre. We already have a physical attacker, which is Rayquaza and Metagross. And now Mew is just going to be our support type Pokemon. I think what I'll do with Mew, okay, so before I say that, here's a power plant, by the way. Isn't it beautiful? But, the other legendary I do really want, if you look on our team, we have Rayquaza and Kyogre. We're just missing one of the weather trio, and that's Groudon. If we can get Groudon, I will make Groudon my, like, stealth rock person. So, he'll have stealth rock, and then, I don't know, earthquake and stuff like that. But, so I guess we'll just have to fucking chill by the desert biome for a little bit, try to train there, and there's our boy Bado Sheets. He was running away from me. He doesn't love me anymore. But yeah, I installed Optifine, as you can see. It helps with a lot of the lag, like the new shopping center that I need to show you guys. Holy shit. Okay, so power plant, you guys haven't seen this on my channel yet, but if you haven't, I'm sorry. If you haven't seen this on any one of the others' videos, I feel sorry for you, because they all have better videos than I do, so that's kind of a shame that you choose to only watch me. But yeah, anyways, there's the power plant. We're gonna be visiting that later, but let's go ahead and go to the shopping center and show you guys all the different floors and stuff. I apologize if you already seen this on someone else's channel, but if you haven't, then I guess this will be your opportunity to see it here. It's by the jungle. And the stuff isn't loading again. Alright, but I do want, like I was saying, I do want Groudon so we can complete the legendary trio, Kyogre, Groudon, and Rayquaza. I think that would be sick to have on a team. And I think Groudon will be a really good addition too, because we can make him like our stealth rock person, the person who sets up like hazards on the field. Not a lot of you guys, well, probably not a lot of you guys will know what I'm talking about, but that's okay. But Groudon spawns in the desert. He spawns in desert hills, and the desert hills, like, biome is near the I believe it's the jungle is this way. Okay, so the shopping center is not too far away, it's just right here. But the desert hills biome is where the Pokemon Center is, and that, like, desert area on the desert island here, so that shouldn't be terrible to catch. I've been there before while I was training, it hasn't spawned, but I know, like, fucking Speedy has it, so it's possible for it to spawn for sure. But so the shopping center is a little bit more updated, a lot of the lag is gone. Once I installed Optifine, it helped even more. Like, I don't get any lag on the, like, bottom floor. It gets a little worse whenever I go up to the top, but it's not, like, bad at all. So I'm just gonna go ahead and heal my Pokemon. I think they're already all healed. But, you know, we can go ahead and do that. But the shopping center is very useful because it allows you to buy a whole bunch of items that you could only obtain through boss drops before. Like, for example, there's elevator blocks here. Joel's using this on his build, and I really want to use it for mine eventually, like maybe for my gym or something like that. But if you stand on the white block right here and you jump or you press spacebar, it takes you to the next level, like where the next elevator block is, and you hit space again, it takes you to this floor. The very first floor is called Balls and Healing, Kind of weird. We're gonna go head over to the balls first, just like anyone else would do. And this fucking girl doesn't even sell balls, so this is a fucking scam. But I bet it's just backwards. So this is not the balls. It's kind of misleading. This is the healing, or this is the balls one. Here we go. No, this is not the balls one either. What the fuck? Are you shitting me? This is called balls and healing. Why is there no balls heal? But here, goddamn, I'm not like. I'm barely saying my words right. Like, not even really that bad or that well. I feel like I should just restart this whole thing, man. This is not going over well, but if you guys see this right now, then I decided not to restart the whole thing. But held items are on this floor. Just walking away from it because I know some of you guys don't like when I call myself bad things. But held item floor right here. If we right-click it, she has different stuff like EXP share, which we're going to pick up one of. We have plenty of... Well, we don't have plenty of money, but we have just an all right amount right now where we can buy it. So we're gonna pick up an AXP share, probably gonna use that for Mew later. There's a whole bunch of stuff you can buy here that you were only able to get through boss shops before. So that's really awesome, I'm really happy. That's the thing. Like Choice Scarf. Oh yeah, so if I hit E right now, you'll see that I kind of decked out my team a little bit with some items. So for my Kyogre, I want him to be like a fast special attacker because he has a move called Water Spout, which does more, it does the max damage whenever Kyogre is at its max HP, like full HP. So by putting a Choice Scarf on it, the Choice Scarf makes him 1.5 times faster, but it locks him into one move. So that basically like sort of, I don't want to say guarantees, but it helps him attack first and make sure that he has full health whenever he uses that first Water Spout at least. And Water Spout's fast or strong enough to pretty much kill anything that doesn't resist it, I'd say. So that's pretty good. Hey, that's pretty good. But and then I gave a life orb to Rayquaza. I don't know if you guys watched Speed's video wherever I told him that I was looking for a life orb or anything like that. But there's that. I still have yet to replace Fly. I'm probably going to replace Fly with some kind of physical fire move. I think is Overheat a physical fire move? I don't know. I have to look that kind of stuff up. But that floor right here, healing. Okay, that wasn't healing and balls. Held items. This guy apparently sells the balls. And by guy, I mean girl. Hold up. I could have sworn you were a guy before. Does this change all the time I come here? Or am I just crazy? Held items? Oh, maybe I was upstairs next to the stat changes, but... let's try that. Hold up. This is kind of tripping me out, dudes. I could have sworn... Oh, TMs. Yeah, okay. Yeah, all right. Okay, no wonder I thought you were a guy, because you were a guy. So, there's that. And for Mew, I think I'm going to put a Leftovers on Mew, but right now I have a Power Weight. It's called... And what that does is it helps him get HP IVs. So every Pokemon I kill, no matter what, I'll get 4 HP IVs. Or EVs, rather, not. So if you do EVS, 6. Just a fresh Mew. I just caught it. So like I showed you guys in the video. So there is that. And the very last floor, I believe. Yeah. The very last floor is stones, power items, and stat boosting. So this is where I bought the power brace or the power weight from. There's a bunch of other ones that help with like EV training and stuff like that. This one's for speed. Don't know what this one's for, and this one's for HP, like I was showing you guys earlier. And these are like the different things that you can use, which I should probably buy, but I don't have that much money. We'll see. Okay. After we conquer the power plant, we'll see how much cash we have, and then we'll try to buy some of those for Mew, because I think that'd be helpful just to save us some extra time and do stuff like that. But you can buy Thunderstones here. Which that'll be pretty good because now I can make the Thunderstone pickaxe or whatever and have efficiency 8 and stuff like that. So I think that'll be awesome. Protein and calcium, I think, I don't actually know off the top of my head what either of those do. I think protein probably boosts attack and calcium defense if I had to guess, but let's head back down. That's the, this is the shopping mart. This lady down here doesn't sell anything. She's just like, hey, you can come back here and like each of the shops refresh once daily. So like every Minecraft day, they sell different items or sell like a different order of items and stuff like that. And there's a Pokemart here and stuff like that. You can no longer, as of right now, you can't buy stuff like gold or diamonds anymore. So it'll be a little bit harder to try to get the blocks from Mewtwo in order to clone him, because for those of you that don't know, I'm kind of, this is like a lot of talking in this episode, so I apologize. I don't know if you guys like that or not, but you have to have the best chance of cloning a Mewtwo. So the way you clone Mewtwo in the first place is you build a cloning machine. Shadow and G18 have done it, and I think D4 has done it too. Like they've tried to, like they have cloning machines or something like that, or they all use it or something similar to that. And you can either use gold, iron, or diamond blocks, and it takes 3 of them to like kind of power the thing, the, like, cloning machine, and, like, each of them give you a different chance for that kind of stuff. Diamond gives you the best chance of it. I think it's 33% or something like that, by using 3 diamond blocks to spawn him. So, it'll be... Before, you were able to buy diamonds, basically, is what I was trying to, like, segue into, and now you can't. So, I don't know if that's going to be changed later or not, but here's the power plant. Let's see what Officer Jenny has something to say, or has something to say. I need to go get help from the others. Okay, so Boss Pikachu here. Should be easy, because we don't have a single person with an Earth-type move, or a Ground-type move. Oh, G18, what up, bro? What it do? Huh? You gonna snatch this? I hope that's how you spell snatch. I think he's typing right now. Nah, alright. Watch us shit on this Pikachu really quick. Meteor Mash. Fuck. Okay, see, he almost died, and it was not even very effective. I should have used Zen Headbutt, it probably would have killed him. Please be something good. I guess it doesn't really matter as much anymore. War Cup, don't know what that is, and don't know what any of these things are either. Awesome. So, okay. I don't know if I was allowed to show that or not. I kind of have to take this precaution. I don't know if he's shown that in the video yet. So, I'm going to ask him afterwards and see whether or not he is okay with me showing that or not. But, so just, if I leave this in, he said okay, and if I don't, then... I guess he didn't. And go check out his channel, see what he had. But there, I guess we just have to heal our Pokemon, then we'll go to the thing really quick, the power plant, and try to kill the people there. I think what my plan is to fight a little bit of the trainers before, and then maybe go over. Well, we'll fight the master dude for sure. But I'm just trying to like gain some extra XP, I guess, at the beginning, and try to see what kind of competition we're up to. I watched Speedy battle and he didn't... I feel like I have... Since my team is all legendaries, practically. Decide if you can heal yourself, cut right here, because I don't know if G18 wants me to show it or not. But here is the power plant. A bunch of Team Rocket scum have taken it over. If you just walk into one of the trainers or have a fucking Clink run into you, then you'll get into a battle, but... I don't think... Let me actually do this really quick. So, EXP share on Mew so we can get some extra stuff. Let's hook it up. Let me show you guys the strength of Kyogre, okay? So, fight this person. Dodrio and Zubat. Oh, I was like, why is my Kyogre not out? But it's a double battle. Okay. Well, I don't want that. Let's do... Hold on. Slash end battle. Just so I can get my lineup. Because I threw Kyogre out first. So, I was like, oh, okay. So, we'll do that. Let's do Kyogre... And Kyogre and let's do Kyogre and Rayquaza, the boys together, you know, does that make sense? Let's throw out, well, awesome. I'm glad I just wasted my time with that. I'm sorry if you guys want to see a double battle, but I guess there's nothing else I can really do. Oh, there we go, two more things, and I can't see anything because it's in my way. So Reuniclus is a psychic type, I believe, so let's go ahead and use Water Spout. It didn't even ask me what I wanted to use it on. It might just attack both of them. Let's do Outrage with Rayquaza. Okay, that definitely does attack both of them. Does that mean that Rayquaza does stuff too to both of them? Outrage, I'm pretty sure, is only a single target move. Oh yeah, see, Mew gained a bunch of XP and then these guys did too. And it's waiting. I think these double battles might be glitched, dudes. We might not be able to battle any of the trainers in this area. Well, I guess we're... gonna end this battle too, I don't know. Do any of these people work, please? Awesome, thank you. See, okay, I'm not even gonna show, well, I'm just gonna Ice Beam, because that's the safest move. And it's not, okay, it did kill it, awesome. Dodrio, okay, Ice Beam again. I guess I'm kind of happy with what I used here. Oh yeah, he had a quick attack anyway, so my Water Spout wouldn't have done max damage, yeah. Mew 51, already level 51. We're gonna have to train that little sucker up. I do really plan on using Mew on my team though, because he can learn any TM. So I'm gonna make him a support person for sure, but I don't know what moves I'm gonna put on him yet, just because I don't know. This fucking Electrode really wants me, dudes. Oh, awesome, thank you. I'm just gonna run away, because level 10 Electrode, are you fucking kidding me right now? But this might be a really good area for me to come train on. Like, go and really choose a target for... Oh, awesome, so Rayquaza does hit both of them? I don't know, man. Screw it. This double battle stuff... I guess... I don't know. It just randomly might choose him. Who knows, dude? It's all good. Who cares? Oh, wait, hold on a second. So, none of you guys might know. at least one of you will know what I'm talking about. So, Rayquaza's ability is Airlock, which makes all weather moves disappear, all weather effects. And Kyogre has an ability called Drizzle, which makes it start to rain right away. So, I don't know which one is prioritized on here, if it's like whoever showed up first or something like that. So, we'll see what happens. Scald, I guess let's do Scald on Dodrio, and then Rayquaza, do what you gotta do. Okay, Scald didn't kill him, which is kind of frightening. Golbat, alright, shouldn't be bad. Let's use Scald again on Golbat. Rayquaza, extreme speed on Dodrio. Please be faster. Alright, awesome. Good job, sir. Scald, alright, awesome. He didn't kill it, and my Rayquaza just got taken out by a Golbat. Alright, no one make a fan art of that. That's pretty embarrassing. Let's do Lugia next. Wait, let's do Mew next. Why not? Mew's fine. Wait, no, it's not. I don't want him. I don't know if this is a glitch or anything like that, but I don't want him to get any EVs from Golbat, so I'm just going to switch into something else. Let's switch into Lugia. Oh, crap. Did I just tell them both to switch into... I don't know, man. Just switch. Both of you just switch, okay? Thank you. Acrobatics. Okay, that's fine, I guess. Let's do Psychic on Zubat, and then let's do Scald on Golbat. I think this is actually really good for XP, dudes. I might be spending a bunch of time here. I think this is kind of, like, cheap, though, too. Because a lot of these Pokemon are level, like, 89, but it seems like so far you can kill almost everything with just, like, an electric move. Or, like, you know, if you have something that's good against... flying type, you should do fine. So I don't know what that was. That was like AIDS or something. Yeah, I guess rest if you can. Why not? Might as well. Okay, you won the battle. Awesome. Now this Clink is going to get into battle with this. Oh, yeah. I couldn't just leave you alone, you know? Person with legendaries on our team, let me just run towards him. Am I right? Well, I think we've pretty much proved we can beat everyone here in this area. But I have to come back. If it's once a day... that's really true. This is a really good training spot, but that might also be a little cheap. Let's just do the bed trick to heal, because it's not like, I mean, what's the worst? You know, are we really that bad of a person for doing this? Let's do that, and then we gotta find the master trainer dude, which I'm not really sure exactly where he is. If I can't, are you kidding me? Are you? And then another one's about to run into me. Okay, maybe not. Awesome. Shelder looks really stupid, so there you go, Shelder. That's what you get. That's what you get for being the stupid screw. I remember... oh, green Pikachu. Should we even try? Sorry, that was kind of like painful for some of you guys. I think my voice cracked during that, too. Man, I'm just messing up left and right in this video. Max Potion and Binding Band. Alright, I don't know what the Binding Band does, but it's probably some kind of breeding thing. Which I'm not gonna do, because you can't breed legendaries. Okay, I went up the stairs. No, I didn't. Went up the stairs. Be careful from the runt Pikachu. And... this way? I know the master dude isn't this guy particularly, but maybe... this guy at the end here will have more, like, stronger Pokemon than everyone else. Maybe if I go through that, it'll take us. Hello, ma'am. Can I... talk to you about Rayquaza for a second. Let's just Dragon Dance once. What is he gonna do anyway? Dragon Dance once for some extra power, and then Outrage and kill pretty much everything he has. Here we go. Yeah, get wrecked, screw. Bunch of freaking screws, I tell you. Houndoom. Oh, Mew level 53. Yeah, you're welcome. And then Houndoom is Fire Dark, so let's go into Kyogre. Let's see who's gonna use a beat up. Okay, that's fine. I'm just gonna use Scald just because in case he has some kind of priority move or someone else later on has some kind of priority move. Vileplume is grass poison. Psychic is good against poison, so let's go into Lugia. I was gonna go into Mew, but I'm afraid it'll die and I don't want it dying. Mega Drain? Okay, I wouldn't have died from that, so. Extra Sensory. Please. Wait, what? Extra Sensory. Ooh. The ballot has occurred. Oh, okay, whatever. Well, you shall not pass. Well, really? That's kind of weird because I just passed. Man, I wonder if these Pixelmon, like, bugs have been fixed in the later versions, because this... I mean, it's not terrible, but it could be a lot better. Alright, the Master Dude is invisible. Slash end battle. Oh, then I have to do it once every day. Okay, maybe we don't slash end battle. Kyogre versus Entei. Should be easy. 77 versus 79. Okay. Here's where I show you. Well, he's a... Okay, I'm just going to Water Spout anyway, because he's going to be faster than them. There we go. Water Spout. Kyogre versus Kyogre. This one is going to be actually a little bit hard. So, let's go into something that can probably take it. Our special wall is Lugia, but it's going to be weak to it. Let's go into Metagross. It might kill it, but screw it. Shiny Kyogre actually looks really cool, and he used Water Spout and Rectus. Okay, so... This could be a lot worse, but let me show you guys why I'm not scared of Kyogre versus Kyogre. And his Kyogre looks a lot better than mine, so well, it's all good. You look beautiful, my Kyogre. So, Thunder normally is a 70% accurate move, so it hits 70% of the time. But since Kyogre spawns like a... it's called Heavy Rain or some shit like that. It's called Rain Dance, the move. But, okay, anyways. He has an ability called Drizzle that summons rain, okay? And Thunder hits 100% of the time whenever it's raining. So, let's hit Thunder. I don't think it'll kill it, but we'll be first next turn anyway. I don't think it can kill us. Yeah, there we go. Water Spout. What's that going to do? Are you serious? Do you think you can kill us with the Water Spout? Raikou, level 79, electric type. Master Ball Guardian sent out Raikou. Okay, pretty weird. Is this the Master Ball Guardian? Pretty weird, am I right? Mew's growing a level. This is awesome, dude. Good job, Mew. And then Kyogre even grew a level. Here are its stats, by the way, in case you're wondering. You know, if I didn't show it before. So Raikou, let's bounce out. Let's go. Lugia's our special wall, so I don't think he'll be able to kill it. Right? Yeah, Spark. It didn't do anything. We don't even have multi-scale. Let's do... Is flying... Are flying moves neutral to electric? They might be. Probably not. Let me just toxic it to be safe. Okay, a critical hit. You're lucky, man. You might actually live. Okay. If he goes faster than me, I'm screwed. So let's roost. Please. Okay, he lived. Barely. Dude, if it wasn't for that crit, that would be way closer. So he's going to take a little bit of damage every turn, and unless he crits me, I should be fine. I'm going to roost one more time just so... Yeah, he's going to hit me again. There we go. All right, we should be fine now. We should be good just to hit it with extrasensory. All right, he's taking quite a bit of a beating. All right, he's going to hit me this turn, so let's go ahead and just roost so we can go ahead and be close to full health whenever... Oh, paralyzed, but can't move. Okay, whatever. Shiny Suicune looks amazing, dude. It's blue hair. Okay, he is water type. We don't really have anything that's electric. Well, we have Kyogre. Let's send out our own Suicune, though, just so we can teach... We can show him who's boss, you know? Ice Fang. Oh, what's that supposed to do to Suicune? Stupid Suicune. Let's... This is my extract, by the way, for stuff. I believe this set is called Crocoon. Like, a lot of... I don't know how that makes sense, but it's all good. Like, maybe... I don't know. Who knows? I'm gonna Calm Mind once... Please don't tell me that's Scald, right? Alright, Bubble Beam, that's all good. I'm gonna Calm Mind once, Calm Mind again, get our stats up a little bit. Bite, that's not gonna do anything to us. And then, if he were to do enough damage to us, he hasn't done enough. But we would rest, and then Sleep Talk lets us use moves while we're sleeping. So, I guess I'll just demonstrate for those of you that aren't super familiar. Bite, there we go. And then Sleep Talk, we'll choose from one of the moves I have. And it'll use it, so it just use rest. That's the worst one we can get. It's random based on that regard, in that regard, I guess. But there we go. Used Calm Mind. So basically, we want either Calm Mind or Scald for this. And I think we're gonna be asleep for one more turn. So let's use Sleep Talk. Oh no, we're not. Well, it's for three turns, but I guess I miscounted. So let's just use Scald again. It's a demonstration. Whatever. Scald did a bunch of damage because it was a critical hit, actually. So never mind. Let's just use Scald again. We can rest later if we really need to. He doesn't have anything else, I don't think. You won the battle. Yeah, that's right. You're welcome to use a processor, but I will continue to test your worth. 39,000 Poké Dollars. All right, thank you. And then you gave us the Beacon Badge, the Bacon Badge. this freaking electrode, dude. What are you, you're just gonna fucking explode in my face or something. This actually looks really cool. I think this is from one of the badges in Diamond and Pearl. And if we go through this room, so we can go to the entrance right here, which no one wants to do that, right? If we go in here, this is where you can heal your Pokemon. So let me do that really quick, I guess. Oh, this might be a really cool spot, because Rayquaza can fly over to, like, whatever place you last healed at. So this might be a cool spot to have it at or something, you know? But entrance or the shiny lab. I believe the shiny lab might get updated soon for... with different traders, I mean, not four different traders. It seems like they kind of moved around since I was last here. But here's all the shiny trades. I can do this, but I'm not going to do it. I already have a Suicune. And I really want to use Mewtwo. So, and Joel already has it anyway. That doesn't make it not cool. I'm just saying, like, I want Mew anyway. So, and I already have a Suicune. So, what would be the point? Okay. I probably won't do that either. I think this is probably the best trade in this whole area. Is Charizard for Crobat. Actually, that reminds me. Frelligator for Tyranitar for Frelligator. Or, okay, I said it right the first time. But this trader right here, if I give him a Mewtwo, I can get a shiny Rayquaza. And here's my thing on that. I've gotten a bunch of comments telling me to do this. Like, because I guess you saw this trade, and let's not bring gender into this side. You saw that trade, and then Blissey for Snorlax. You saw that trade in, like, someone else's video, and you're like, hey, Sad really likes Rayquaza, so he can get shiny Rayquaza. And I really do want shiny Rayquaza, but I think if I got a Mewtwo, I would rather use that, because I already have a Rayquaza, you know? So it's like... what's the point? You know, does that make sense? Yeah, I could get him shiny, but then you run the risk of, you know, maybe him having, you know, like a bad nature or bad IVs or something like that. And I'm really happy with what mine is right now, plus or minus special defense plus attack. I think the only way it could have been better is plus attack minus special attack, since we don't have any special moves. But yeah, I think that's the only way it could have been better. And then it's IVs are pretty all right too. I mean, I would say the biggest thing I'd be scared about if I traded Mewtwo for a shiny Rayquaza would probably be the nature, because I don't think we're probably gonna get a better one than this. I think it's really low, a really low chance that we'll get the same one, or that one where it's like plus attack minus special attack. But if you see the differences, he's just kind of like murdered out. He has like a black and yellow theme, and I don't think, yeah, he still has the red parts in his back based on that picture. But he does look really cool. I'll give you that. But I think if I got a Mewtwo, I would either use it on my team or use it as like a trading thing. So like if someone, like if Speedy didn't want his Groudon or something, I could be like, hey man, I'll trade you Mewtwo for my Groudon or something like that, you know? Now that might not be like a completely fair trade, but I really do want Groudons. That would be fair like based on the demand, you know? I'd be like, I really want a Groudon and I don't want to spend the whole time in the desert hills trying to catch one. So let's trade, man, or something like that. But actually looking on this now, and, like, coming to the trader and, like, actually having the possibility of getting a Mewtwo if I make, like, a trading or a cloning machine and stuff like that, I might actually do this. But I guess let me know how you guys feel. I know, like, a lot of you guys are more into Pokemon than I am and know a lot more about it, too. I'd say probably the majority of you guys know a lot more than I do, too. At least in some aspects. I'm not, like, terrible at Pokemon. I, like, know how to battle. At least I think I know how to battle. So, let me know what you think about this. I already have a Rayquaza. But getting a shiny one would be pretty cool, but I just don't know, I don't think it's worth a Mewtwo. Does that make sense? Especially since we already have one, and then you'd run the risk of it being, like, a shitty nature, or, like, worse IVs than what I have right now. But I guess that kind of stuff shouldn't really matter, I suppose. Like, if I like how a Pokemon looks, I should just trade for it, because, I mean, what's the fucking worst that can happen, you know? I won't have, like, two more fucking points in my special attack or something like that, you know? Like, in the stat. So, let me know how you guys feel about that. I guess I'd have to EV train it too, but it's all good. We'll figure it out. As of right now, I'm kind of on the fence about it. I'm leaning towards no. Like, if I had a Mewtwo right now, I would not do it. But once, if I get one, I might want to do it. I don't know if any of this making sense. You guys know I'm not very good at talking about this kind of stuff, so... Thank you all very much for watching. Oh, yeah. Also, oh, yeah. So, one more question before I leave. So, please let me know about what you guys think about me trading a Mewtwo for a shiny Rayquaza. Rayquaza is my favorite Pokemon. I think its shiny version looks awesome. But we already have one, and we don't already have a Mewtwo. Does that make sense? So, it's kind of, like, weird if we do it. But let me know what you think about that. And also, whenever we beat that Master guy, he said something like, you're free to use the processor or something like that. And he's the Master Ball Guardian. So is there a way we can get a Master Ball with this? I know it's kind of like this kind of exclusive to our server, sort of. Like, or like basically what I'm asking is, has anyone else figured out what that means? Like, can you go over to this block right here, right click, and it's like, oh, this is a processor. You can get a Master Ball from here, and it just gives it them, you know? So let me know if anyone's done that. I don't think they have, otherwise they would have told us, you know? But, yeah. So thank you all very much for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you guys next time. Later, fellas. So the video is not ending. I forgot to show this at the very beginning, even though I was right over there and I didn't, like, think about it. But D4 pranked us, actually. If you guys want to go check out D4's prank on his channel, please go ahead and do that. But what he did is he put down a bunch of ranch blocks. And what these do, if you've seen these on Shadows episodes or anything like that, or even D4's prank episode on his own, these allow you to put Pokemon in them and then with, like, have them roam around the area that this thing is, like, it's like a 6-block range or something like that. They can roam around here. Pokemon you set. And you put a bunch of Ladybugs in there, and Ladybugs are Ladybug Pokemon, so get it. Oh, Sodom says it's Ladybugs. And it's fucking annoying having them say Ladybug over and over again, but they're not here right now. I don't know if they just don't breed during the night or they go back into the ranch block or something like that, but I don't see them right now. So there's that. So that's a good thing. I mean, I don't fucking want Ladybugs around my stuff. What if they turn into thieves and fucking take all my TMs and shit? But there's that. I just want to kind of show you guys this because I told them about it, or I told them that I would and stuff like that. So please go check it out and let me know what you think. It's actually pretty funny whenever I found it. I didn't expect anyone to do this. I didn't even think that you could, like I didn't think of the Ladybug stuff, basically is what I'm trying to say. And then if you remember, a couple episodes ago, we battled a trainer and it gave us a duplicate badge. And then BZ, he wrote this, he says, fix your double quake badge, heart. And then he put a 1G after it. So everyone knows I'm a big fan. So let's put that over here. I believe this would be considered a sort of like specialty type of badge. Not really a gym leader type of thing. Like, he wasn't really a gym leader. So I'm going to leave the rest of these here and keep this one separate. Just to kind of like make it so, I don't know. It's kind of easy for me to tell. But actually, I should probably just get this into like a separate chest or something. But yeah, there's that. And let me know all that stuff I asked you guys before, like the Rayquaza stuff. I don't know. I'm just gonna go ahead and end the video off here because it's already weirder than it should be. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Later, fellas.